So for those who don't know me, my name is Katelyn. I obviously work for Bangor, but I've worked for Bangor for probably close to 9 or 10 months now with Sage 100 Contractor. And I think I've worked with most people that have registered for this class so far, but if I haven't, please feel free to reach out and we can always schedule an introductory call. I love working with new clients and kind of getting to know different types of businesses and different clients that we have. So today we're going to be going over inventory management. And really, this module is designed to help keep track of how much money you have tied up on hand. So this class is really just going to be an overview of what the inventory module can do, how you can navigate through some basic fundamentals of it, and how to best record some of these ideas. So I'll show you a few different tricks and tips that I've come across, and we'll give a very broad macro level of the inventory management. So you guys should be seeing my Sage 100 screen. And today I'm going to be operating in the sample company just because everyone has the capability of having the sample company on their machine. And that really just has the same fake data, fake employees, fake inventory, fake everything. So none of the information that you see here will be related to any type of client or anything that is real life, if you will. So this will just give us a very basic overview. I think the sample company, to its origin, is based off of just a general contractor. So take that as you will. But a lot of the parts and things that we'll review today, you guys can also view in the sample company on your own. So also, fair warning, we are still working from home, so if you hear my cat in the background, he loves participating in these classes, so fair warning. So let's get started. First off, I want to introduce just the modules on the far left side, and this will be kind of 101 for the first few minutes, so if you already know this, feel free to take this as a coffee break, but on the left-hand side, we have all of our modules that Sage 100 Contractor can offer. Mine may look a little different. I have all of the modules unlocked here, if you will. And then there's some modules that are add-on modules. So for example, equipment management, estimating, service receivables, and inventory, all of those modules are add-on modules. So they don't come with the basic core package. So with inventory, which is the one we're going to focus primarily on today, inventory also is kind of special in itself in that it pulls items from estimating, it can relate to service receivables, it has several different places where it occurs in the system. So if you're looking at adding the inventory module, please note that you can pull from any of the other modules in the software to get that inventory. So we will start with just basic inventory terminology for Sage 100. Inventory is really anything that will have a cost to it. It doesn't have to be necessarily a 2x4 piece of material. It can be anything that you store that has a monetary value to. Throughout the course of inventory, you have the options to allocate that towards jobs that are either contract jobs. You can apply it there. You can apply it to service invoices, and then you can also audit inventory against your physical counts that you may do quarterly, semi-annually, or annually. So in the inventory module, there are several places that we'll need to look at first before we access these items. The easiest way is to go into the estimating module and go to parts. And that way you can access any of the parts that you want to. Whenever we're putting in these items, whether it's in a part, again, is something that just has a monetary value to it, doesn't necessarily have to be a box of screws or a piece of material. We'll put in the description. And if you have the inventory module already purchased, you will have this tab. You'll also have this button down here. So this is where a lot of our, when we're inputting inventory for the first time, we can do, we'll make a new part here. And let's just call, we'll do a demo part here. And now let's do just anything down here. So I'm just going to make up a part so we're all seeing how the process works for doing this. And in no particular order, I'm just going to do 10,000 as my part number. That's just a numeric number as a list number. You can change that if you want. We're just going to call this test. And the unit, I'm just going to put each. This alpha part number can be something that your company tracks internally. So maybe it's T1234, something like that. You'll put part classes and cost codes. And if you want to use the scheduling factor, you can put in a task that's associated. And we'll go over this in when we talk about the estimating module in a different class. But once you have this test part, you'll shimmy on over to this inventory category. Now, if this is a stock item, this means that when you pull it from a job or you're doing an allocation, that you can pull from what you have in inventory versus creating a purchase order for it on the spot. So it's more of an efficient, productive way of using your inventory. You'll also put where you are storing this item, where the location of this item is. For this example, the sample company has a warehouse on there as where it's stored. If you're wanting to add more locations, to add another location option, you'll go down to inventory locations and add a couple more options for you. Maybe you have different company locations, different warehouses that you can use. When you put in the cost of the item and you multiply that by the amount that you have on hand, that is where you will get your inventory amount that you have on hand. So if this piece was $10 a piece and I had five of them, I would have $50 in my inventory account. To a very simplistic way of looking at that. But that's kind of the point, is that it'll take the cost that you have tied up in inventory and put that in your account for you. If this is a serialized item, that means that there is a serial number attached to it. And then if it's required from inventory, this is again when you're pulling from your parts, that it's gonna pull from the inventory. A lot of these items are the same when you look at stock item and required from inventory. The required is saying that it's always going to check first if you have them in the warehouse or in the default location before creating that PO. And then if you are a serialized item, you can put in the serial number and when you stocked that part specifically. I'm going to click on this inventory button down here, and it's going to prompt me to save my new part that I've made. And this is where you can view your different pieces of inventory, how much you have on hand, how much you have available. Those are probably the two biggest parts of one piece. So if I had six or seven locations that this part was stored in, it'll tell me in each location how much I have there and how much is available for me to use. So step one is to make sure that all of your inventory items are listed in the parts section. So that way you can put them to jobs, increase and decrease your inventory. So let's talk about how to apply inventory to a job. So you're on a job, you're needing to grab some inventory, you need to mark it in Sage 100. The first step is to open 8-2 allocation. This is where pretty much every single I say pretty much because I feel like there's always an exception, but pretty much all of your adjusting of inventory will happen in the 12-2 allocation screen. So we're going to pop that open here. You'll put in your ticket number. So let's just say this is, again, a test field. And we're gonna put this to one of the jobs that I have going. So let's say we're gonna make a post office. I don't have any phases on this job. And we're gonna keep going over here. The date is going to pre-fill to what today's date is automatically, but you can adjust this manually. And this will default to shift, which is okay. We'll put in the description here. And this can be as broad or specific as you want, but we'll just put test description. And down here is where I'm going to pull in that part number. So we did part 10,000. That's the part that we just created. It's going to pre-populate those items. And here is where I'm going to put the quantity or the number of parts of that part that I'm going to use. So I'm just going to use one of them. I didn't put a cost in my test part, so the cost is not pulling through. But let's just say this is a $10 part. So now my total is going to be $10. I didn't put a serial number in there. So there's not going to be a serial number. And it's going to come from the warehouse. And then I would put my account number for posting. So this is the job expense account number. I'm not going to save this because I have other jobs that are coming through on this one, but this is where you'll put in your job expense account number. And then if there's any subsidiary account that you want to put in there, you can put that in as well. And that way, it pulls it from this job. So there are several ways you can add it to a job. That is the best way in the 3-5 jobs to put it in the job underneath that job part. So now if I was to go to 3-5 and find that post office job, let me pop this open here. I have all of my information down here. Inventory is not one of the buttons down here. But this is where you'll find all of the information about your job itself. And if you want to see what we just did, if I had saved that, I can go into inventory reports and do my inventory journal. So some easy ways to kind of track what we were just able to do. So that's just a very overview of how to apply inventory to a job. Now let's look at if we're doing a physical inventory account at the very end of the year, and we're wanting to make sure that Sage matches up with that. There are several ways we can go about that. So let's pull up here, and we're going to go back into our 12-2, our inventory allocation. And this is where adjustments will be done as well. So if you need to account for inventory shrinkage, any type of inventory adjustment, this is where we'll do that as well. The only trick here is that we're not going to put in a job. We're not applying it. We're just doing it for the company as a whole. We'll put in our part number. We'll again call this $10. Here's the trick about this. If we are wanting to, if our quantity is too high, we're going to enter it in the source cell. If we need to, so we'll put in source as, I think 100 is warehouse. And then we're going to enter in the location. So in the source cell, we're going to enter where the part is coming from if our quantity is too high. We're going to use the destination box if we need to add to the quantity. So source is to subtract, destination is to add. So sources we're taking away, destinations we're adding to it. So that's the only kind of caveat about this is when you're doing your adjustments, this is where you'll make that adjustment. And you can do it in the same line item. So if I had, I was doing it for the full year, I could do part 50, put all that information in there, and I can put in a source there. I needed to, I don't even know. I'm assuming some of these parts are already created in here. And let's say I needed to add more to here. I will put the warehouse as my destination. So this is where you'll do the adjustments part as well. You can't do the inventory adjustments in the journal transactions itself. It'll prompt you to come to the inventory allocation page. So this is the best way to go about this. But before you do this, you have to have, you know, a license for the inventory module to do this process. So if you need to increase the inventory quantity, you'll use the destination column. If you need to subtract inventory in Sage 100, you'll use the source column. So there's different ways to go about tracking inventory, and that's probably the best way is to put it as a part and then put it through to which location it's going to if you're adding or subtracting. Once you have several pieces of inventory tied to a job, there are several reports that will probably be very beneficial for you. So you can do an allocation list. That's probably the easiest report to pull, and I'll just generate this with no filters on it. And I've put through a couple inventory pieces on here for my startup inventory to see where I'm at for my allocation list. The quantity on hand will tell you at any given point what you have in Sage 100 Contractor. And you have several different filters here you can do with location on there. If you have multiple locations, we'll do this one just to show you guys what the quantities look like. So I have this part number, the description, and I have 12 of these in my warehouse. So at this point, when you're doing your physical count inventory, you can see when at any given point, or you know, where all of your inventory is tied up at. And then if you're wanting to do an inventory journal, you can do by entry or by part. I typically do by part. It'll show me, okay, I had this fan motor and I've had three entries of this, and I can drill down on this invoice. On these come from the payable invoice screen, and you can see the different accounts that they use. They did use their inventory account, so that's their default account for this setting. And then before you do this, you'll need to select if you're a LIFO or FIFO, last in, first out, or first in, first out for your valuation method. Okay, so we've gone through the reports, we've gone through allocation, and we've gone through location. The other two options in the inventory module are purchase order receipts, which is just you'll confirm it here and put in your receipt information. And that's pretty standard. You'll put in what was ordered on that PO. And then you also have an option to audit your inventory. So oftentimes before you're archiving your books, you can audit your inventory. So the audit itself performs several different checks. I mean, it verifies a few different things against your inventory module. It'll verify your inventory GL account balances with all of your transactions. It will make sure all of the inventory part quantities are correct, so what you have on hand. And then it'll also it'll look at the inventory GL account balances with the valuation of all the parts that we have in inventory. So you can run an audit at any given point. You don't have to just do it at the end of the year or when you're archiving data. You can perform this task at any part throughout your time, as long as you're pretty much up to date. So you'll want to run this once you've maybe entered in an allocation, something after you've made some changes to your inventory module. Would you want to audit this? So if the audit, if we run it and it doesn't detect any errors, which is the goal here, we know that it was completed. If you do get errors, we can print a report. So we'll run through here. I haven't ran this audit in quite some time, so there may be some errors, okay, or not. And it'll say this, there was no report items that were needed to be fixed. But if it did, much like a payroll audit, it'll give you the list of the items that are off. So you can go in and fix those. And then you can also do a repair once those items have been fixed. So if the audit detects any discrepancy between the inventory GL account and the total valuation of all of the parts, it'll give you the option of having Sage 100 create the default automatic journal entry adjustment for it. The adjustments made to both the GL and inventory offset accounts. And so it'll prompt you to have that journal entry if there are any variances. Otherwise, it'll give you a list of the items that need to be fixed. So a pretty comprehensive inventory approach. It'll give you the items that you need to repair. You can also put this towards a job. You can also pull reports to see where your inventory is tied up. But the whole point of this is to get your GL inventory account balances to equal and to show your company how much you have sitting in your warehouse at any given point. Do we have any questions so far? Let me pop up here and see if there's any questions. I think there were a few. So how does quantity get reduced in inventory? So we will do that from the source in that inventory allocation. Okay, what is the inventory offset account? Okay, good question. So this offset account, let me pull it up here. So oftentimes it'll prompt you for your inventory offset account. And the offset really just notates any differences that come from the system when you're looking at invoice price compared to the item's value, based on if you're a LIFO or FIFO company. And so it's really just to hold any differences that you can need to make that adjustment for. So kind of like on that repair, we had talked about if there are any variances, Sage 100 will prompt you to make the inventory adjustment in the journal transaction for the inventory offset account. And that's really just to notate any differences in the system. So that's not where your inventory is actually held as far as value. That is more of for any kind of cleanup and repair, as I call it. All of your money will be tied up in your inventory account. So if I had that one test part at $10 a part, and I had five of those, my inventory account should reflect $50 if I had those on hand. Good question. Are there any more questions on this? Okay. All right, so that is all I have for today on this class. Let me pull up one thing I wanted to review with everybody that's on here, because I know as soon as you guys get into this, that is when all of the questions will start. That's where you'll often refer back to this video, which is totally okay. But that's when you'll start thinking about the what ifs and how can this apply to my company. So one thing I want to direct your attention to, and this is our YouTube page. So every week I upload at least one video of Sage 100 Contractor Notes. So this is our homepage, Bangerinc at YouTube. And there's several different playlists that you can go through. But here I have a Sage 100 Contractor playlist that you guys can view. Looks like there's a 49-ish videos up there for everybody to take a look at. This is a free resource, and there are some inventory module videos on there, along with service receivables, parts, how to create a part. Everything that I've covered today, there's a little bit more of a detailed video on YouTube for it, or there will be here shortly. And so that's a good way to kind of get your feet wet on how how comfortable you feel doing these items, making sure everything is set up to the way you want it to be. So I would definitely check out this page. The best way to get in contact with me, and I'll type it out here on a notepad. Let me pull up a Word document. For those, I think most people in this have my email, but for those who don't, I will put it up on the screen for us. The best way to get in contact with me. All right. Well, if there's no more questions, I will turn you guys loose. Have a great day. If you have more questions and you didn't feel comfortable asking, or you want to kind of follow up one-on-one, please shoot me an email or give me a call. Here's my direct line. Give me a call and we can always talk more company-specific approaches to this. But either way, I look forward to working with you guys, and we will talk soon.